Hi, my name is Cadence, and in this video, I'm going to break down all the basic things you need to know about chromosomes. These are chromosomes. A chromosome is typically a single molecule of tightly coiled, double-stranded DNA that contains both genes and non-coding DNA, making up the genome. Prokaryotes typically have a single circular chromosome, but let's focus on eukaryotes for now. Every chromosome has one centromere, a pinched point roughly in the middle of the chromosome. From the centromere, there are two arms. If one is smaller, then that one is called the P arm, P like petite, and the other is called the Q arm. The shape of a chromosome is determined by the length of the P arm relative to the Q arm. If the arms are roughly the same in length, then the chromosome is metacentric. If the two arms are close in length, but one is distinctly shorter than the other, then it's submetacentric, sort of metacentric. If the P arm is very small compared to the Q arm, then the chromosome is acrocentric. If there's no P arm, then it's telocentric because the centromere is at the telomere, which is the last part of the chromosome. At the end of each arm is a telomere. These are the ends of your chromosomes. Because bacterial chromosomes are circular, they have none of these. No telomeres and no centromeres. The number of centromeres is what defines the number of chromosomes. In this image, there are four centromeres, so there are four chromosomes. Sometimes you will see chromosomes drawn like this. These chromosomes have two DNA molecules each, and they each only have one centromere, meaning these are still four chromosomes. The main example of this is sister chromatids, which are two identical DNA molecules that remain attached at the centromere until they are separated during anaphase in the cell cycles. This can be kind of confusing at first, but think of them as temporarily conjoined twins, DNA molecule twins. It might help to think of some chromosomes as certain kinds of siblings. Sister chromatids are like identical twins. And using this analogy, you could also look at homologous chromosomes as fraternal twins. They're very similar, but they have some different traits, some different alleles at some genes. Moving on, this is a karyotype. Karyotypes are visual images of the stained chromosomes from a cell. These can be taken both from before or after S phase, so sometimes you will see karyotypes with sister chromatids. Chromosomes are ordered by size, ending with the sex chromosomes. They can also be differentiated by shape, like meta, submeta, acro, or telocentric, and by banding pattern. In karyotypes, you can see this banding pattern on the chromosomes. This is created by the dye used to stain them. The darker bands indicate areas where there's a lot of DNA that's tightly packed, and these areas are called heterochromatin. They are mostly present in areas where there's not a lot of coding DNA, such as the telomeres and the centromere of each chromosome. The lighter bands, called euchromatin, indicate areas with more loosely packed DNA. This will be important to remember when you start covering gene expression. While banding pattern is explored more thoroughly in research and genetic mapping, in this course, you don't need to track every locus of heterochromatin and euchromatin, especially for differentiating between chromosomes. I mean, you can, but you'll just get a giggling chromosome. Most eukaryotes are diploid, although certain types of cells within eukaryotes, such as gametes, are haploid. You can tell if an organism's cell is haploid or diploid by its karyotype. The most karyotypes you see will be diploid. The haploid number is indicated by N, and the diploid number is 2N. You can tell an organism is haploid or diploid by its karyotype, because if it's diploid, you should notice that there are two of each chromosome, with the exception of the sex chromosomes, which can sometimes appear different from each other, like X and Y chromosomes. As you can see with this karyotype, there are two 1 chromosomes, two 2 chromosomes, etc. These pairs are homologous chromosomes. They have the same genes, but they can have different alleles, so they're not identical. Typically, one comes from each parent. Like I mentioned before, you can maybe think of them as fraternal twins, very similar, but not quite the same. There are 12 different pairs, so the haploid number is 12, and there are 2 chromosomes in each pair, so the diploid number is 24. That's everything I can think of for the basics on chromosomes. Hopefully you found this video helpful. Good luck on your exam!